Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, Satan, your kingdom is coming down. They came unto the iron gate that leadeth unto the city, which opened to them of its own accord. And they went out and passed on. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately all the doors were open, and everyone's bonds were loosed. Acts 12, verse 10, Acts 16, 26. What do gates and doors have in common? Both are designed to keep the unwanted out and the wanted in. In most cases, they help us keep the good in and the bad out. However, in the two cases given above, they were designed to keep the good in. Gates, doors, fences, and walls also represent boundaries and are usually easy to see. They bear the unwritten message, "This is my property, keep out." These boundaries also exist in the spiritual realm, but they are just a little bit more difficult to see. Matthew 16 verse 18 records, "And I say unto you that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." Wrapped up in this one verse is the purpose, the plan, the mission, and vision of God. This was the reason why Jesus came on the earth. He came to build his church, and he still continues to build it through us. Many times when we read this verse, we picture hell on the attack and the church on the defensive. We picture ourselves almost sunken under the pressure of hell's onslaught, and God finally is able to bring together enough forces to overcome the wicked one. That is not the picture portrayed here at all. Have you ever seen a person attack with gates? No, a person does not attack with gates. He defends with gates. Do you get it? Jesus and his mighty army, which is the church, are attacking, and the devil is on the run. Let us go back into history and get a clear picture. In this case, history will become his story. One of God's leaders in the angelic realm was Lucifer, the son of the morning, who tried to overthrow God in a coup. He became God's adversary. Because of this, Lucifer was moved from being one of God's archangels to God's arch enemy. Revelation 12 tells us that Lucifer tried to get all the angels to follow him, but only one third of the angels joined him in the coup attempt against God. They were cast down and had to organize their own kingdom. The Bible is a battle between good and evil. When you look at the back of the book, you will see who wins. Until then though, we will constantly be in battle against Satan and against his demons. It is true that Satan is our enemy, and we are coming against the gates of his kingdom. The gates of hell cannot withstand the mighty army of Jesus Christ. Satan's gates are being pulled down and his doors kicked open, and the church is aggressive and triumphant against it. Satan is the god of this world. He controls it along with his demons and evil spirits. He has organized the world into political, cultural, and religious systems that are at times stands as gates against the kingdom of God and prevents the people of God from believing the truth. Although Satan has a powerful kingdom, Jesus came to destroy the works of Satan and free us from his dominion. He has given to us powerful weapons and a promise that no weapon formed against the church shall prosper. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, through the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imagination, and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God. No matter what gates of hell are in our lives, homes, and city, we can knock them down with the weapons provided. It is true that the enemy has built his gate very close to where we live. Satan tries to hinder the preaching of the gospel. It is his desire to hide the truth from people. He knows there's one God and trembles with fear. Numbers 13 reminds us, "Let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it." We must use our spiritual might to put out the enemy who occupies our territory illegally. We can possess the land. It is yours. The thought of the day: no matter what the gates of hell are in our lives, homes, and city, we can knock them down with the weapons provided. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.